Hello everyone and welcome. In this particular video, we are going to discuss some of the great technologies out there to further enhance Common Core close reading. And one of my favorite tools, especially for mobile devices in the classroom, cell phones, tablets, whatever, is PollEverywhere.com. Okay, PollEverywhere.com. This is a great site that allows you to create any kind of poll, mostly multiple choice questions and or open-ended questions. And you could post those questions on your screen in your classroom, and students can text in their responses. It's very versatile. Students can use a regular, I'll use the term, dumb phone that only has texting capabilities, or they can use their smartphones, or they can use a tablet, or they can even use a computer in the classroom to text in or type in their responses to any question that you put on the screen. Now, how can you use this for a close reading? Well, we'll get to that in a moment, but let me just show you how this actually works. So here we are. We're in Poll Everywhere. Just create. You can go into create a poll. All right, and this is so easy. This is really great. Now, this tells you all the different plans here. Now, we're going to use the free plan, which is really what I've been using for the past couple years. It's free. You don't have to pay any prices for this. You get about 40 students in a classroom. Now, hopefully your class size hasn't increased beyond 40, so you should be okay. You can get a teacher plan, and you can kind of see the side-by-side comparison here. Teacher plan is nice, and the best, how should I say it, features that it has over the free plan is that you can actually grade students' responses, which is really, really, really nice. What that means is with the paid plan is that you actually have students register their phones or their devices with you. Now, you'll never know their phone number, right? But you'll know who texts in what particular response. Okay, so they type in their phone number when they register into your site, and you'll know, you know, John Smith typed this in or Susie typed this in. It also allows you to approve which responses are displayed on the screen. It's kind of like a moderator sort of a function, which is nice. Now, this is the problem with the free plan. With the free plan, you know, a student in your classroom wants to text something and it posts on the screen in real time, you have no control over what that student posted. Now, when I first started using this product, you know, I was really worried about that, and I always made sure I had the teacher plan. But after a while, I realized, you know, students really enjoy using this, and I made it a point to understand this is a privilege that we're using these phones and cell phones and tablets in the classroom. And if you want to lose that privilege, it's really easy, is if you text something in that's inappropriate. And they really respected that, and I've never had a problem with anybody texting something in that was inappropriate. Now, will they text something in that's silly? Yeah. Usually it's kind of funny, yes. Nothing that was really bad or inappropriate. So you have to kind of gauge your students and see what, you know, might happen with that. So you might want to invest in the $50 per year. I actually think it actually is worth the money. Usually these plans, everybody wants to make money off these sort of products, and they're usually unnecessary. But in this particular case, I think this really is a great, great product. Okay, now let me go into the poll section here. Okay, it lists all my polls, and when you start making polls, your list will become greater and greater. And you see, I have a lot of polls here, some quizzes, and I start organizing them. I should probably organize them all better by different readings and different assignments, different topics, and things like that. Okay, so how do you create a poll, and what does it actually look like? Let's just kind of do it really, really, really quickly. You create a poll, click that button on the left-hand side, and now you just type in your question. And you could type in an open response question. Let's just type something general in. You know, how is your summer? Okay, now, once you type in your question, you have the opportunity to decide whether you want it to be an open-ended poll or multiple choice. Multiple choice, then you can collect either true, false, or you can add answers. You can add images, which is really neat. Okay, or you can add different answers, and now you can have an actual multiple choice question. Most of the time for Common Core close reading, I'll use open-ended questions. And then if you just want to, you can create another poll right in this particular screen if you want to create a few polls that are maybe perhaps linked together. So here we go. I'll press create. How is your summer? Okay, and voila, we have a poll. Okay, now this is really neat. This is all it is. Students have to just text in this number. I'm going to go into full screen here. It's kind of neat. Students basically use their cell phones. In the two box, okay, they type in 37607. This will always be the same number for you as a teacher, so they can actually add it to their contacts. And then in the message box, they type in 27704, space, and then write their answer. And once they click send or submit, boom, that response appears in real time. Okay, I guess I can play around this a little bit. I have my cell phone with me here. I'll do the message one. Okay, so I'll type in my message. I'll type in, which you can see this, 37607, and then I'm going to type in the number, okay, 27704, space, and I'll just type in a message. It has been great. And I press send. And now it should appear very quickly. Let's see how fast it is. Look at that. It's been great. So a couple seconds, bam. All right. And now you will see students' messages appear, you know, in that real time very, very, very quickly. Now, what's all this stuff? You could push this poll to other devices, okay? Let me escape out of this full screen. You can kind of play around with this. You can clear your results here. You could turn the poll on and off. You can play around with how you want it to look visually. But now you want to push to this, and I'll talk about that. I push it to other spots. Okay, let me just, and you can then go to the next poll, which is really neat, right inside here. So if you had a couple polls together, you want to keep on using them, you're all set, ready to a go. All right, let's kind of get out of the full screen mode. Now, how can students respond? Okay, this is how, on the right-hand side here, they could text their messages in. They could also use Twitter. If you use Twitter with your students, some teachers do, you can have a Twitter account, you can have a link to it. They can use their web devices. This is why I pushed it out. So basically, if they have a web device, meaning a smartphone, and they go to your site, all right, which is poll for me, pollev.com/Dr. Kotlik, bam, they'll actually see the poll on their smartphone. They don't have to use their text. They have a smartphone or a tablet in the classroom, and you know, they can just type in their response. It looks really, really, really neat. You can also have a private link. And I've used this. If you click on this private link right here on the right-hand side, try it now. All right. This is how it actually looks on their smartphone, too, which is kind of neat to actually show you this. But if here's this web address. If you copy this web address and you press copy, and all of a sudden now you could post this poll on your website. If you have a website or something that you use, all you have is the link. You're all set, ready to go. Students can also respond to this on their own time at home. So, again, got a lot of versatility here. You can use it in the classroom. You can use it with a cell phone. You can use it with a smartphone. You can use it with a tablet. You can use it with a PC or a Mac in your classroom. Or you can use it at home. Students, if you have a website where you post material. Really neat. And I've used all the functions of it, and it works wonderful. Okay? So let me go back to the poll editor here. Okay? So that's kind of some of the things you can do with it. You can also do some really cool things, too. You can embed it right into a PowerPoint slide. You can share it and actually put it into a Prezi, which is kind of neat. Really, 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 really fun with that. You can also do some fun things. You know, if ever used, we're going to talk about Wordles and word walls later on. But you can actually make a word wall out of the responses that students put into this particular poll if they're mostly one word responses, which is really kind of neat. So there's just so much you can do with this, with the PowerPoints and how people can respond and the views, and there you can create a word cloud, which is really kind of fun. Okay, now let's go into some of my polls here so you can see what I've used for this. Okay, so I'll go back into my polls, and I just have a lot of things here that are not as organized. But, I mean, here is just some quick things for Common Core close reading. You know, define the thesis. okay, in a short phrase. Okay, so they're reading a short passage. What was the author's thesis? And they can kind of post that. And I'll show you some examples of that. Okay, that's one just real simple example. Which here's another one I use a lot. Here's the I think I have some responses here. Which quote from the document did you choose? I asked them to think what was the most, important quote, what was, what and things like that. And we'll kind of put it in full screen here. And this is what it will look like. They just come up, boom, boom, boom. And if you click on one of these, it gets bigger. So there you go. All right. Now this is really kind of neat because what you can do is basically this is a great discussion starter in class. All right, so students are texting their responses based on a particular passage, and now you can talk about those particular student examples. Maybe you're seeing the same quote come up over and over and over again. Well, why is everybody choosing this particular quote, this particular passage? Things for in that way. So and again, you can kind of highlight one, and you can talk about it. It's also great for that student who is a little bit shy, apprehensive about speaking in class. All of a sudden, they're involved in the conversation, even without having to physically raise their hand. They feel a part of the classroom discussion. And oftentimes, once they text their response in, that student might be now more inclined to, verbalize and explain why they chose that quote. It's really a fun tool. Okay, so there's one exa there's there, there's some examples of that. Some other things I can show you here quickly. Things like that. I don't really have. Here's another one. Like, what was Murray's argument? This is from my Civil War class. All right, and talking about a particular article written by a historian named Murray. Toggle full screen. Okay, so there you go. Boom. There's his argument. There's another argument. Okay. Things like that. So that's really, really fun. So have fun with this. I think this is a really great tool. You can do a lot with it. You can group polls, you can download messages, PowerPoints, things like that. Yeah, and this is really, you really have fun and play with this tool. Okay, great. Hope you enjoy this and have a great day.